what's up? geology. Science.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Blessing Anyam here, and today this vlog is a continuation of my previous video where I followed my husband to his school. If you have not watched that video, please click down and watch the video. So while I was in my husband's office just sitting down and editing my videos, one of his students stopped by. Her name is Blue. Yeah, I've met her several times. Whenever I'm in the office, she will just stop by and say hello to me. So I had a chat with her, and then she decided to show me some beautiful rocks in their department. She explained a lot, and I was so grateful to learn from Blue, and she showed me the dinosaur bone and everything. So you guys are going to hear directly from her, and I hope you learn a thing or two about geology. Yeah. Blue loves geology so much, so enjoy the video.
geology.
So this is Blue, my Hello. New friend at Hope College.
Hello, freshman student.
So Blue, you're appearing on my channel.
I got dinosaur bone. You know what's up? What's good here at college? Got dinosaur bones.
Oh my god.
All right, so I'm going to talk about some of the rocks they have in the display case over here. A lot of these were collected from Michigan. Some of these were collected from out of state. Right over here, if you come over here, you can see some cubes of galena or pyrite. Wow. I think that's actually pyrite, not galena. And on some, I think, calcite.
Pyrite, is it a mineral?
It's a mineral. It's iron sulfide. And next to that, we have a banded iron formation, one of the oldest rock formations in the world.
Wow.
These are older than the continent of America. So,
are you serious?
Very serious indeed. It's got a mix of hematite and jasper. So it's also called a jaspelite formation as well.
Wow.
Here's some raw copper ore, you know, make...
I know copper.
Yeah, earrings, pipes, a lot of things made out of copper.
Yeah.
You got quartz used to make glass. It's very, very shiny. Wow. Down here we have a piece of gypsum. Gypsum when it's not
like
that
a flower.
Form. Yeah, it's also called that variation of it's called desert rose. Gypsum is used to make cement and like drywall, whatever that's
How
called.
How do you have these things at your fingertip?
I've taken because three geology classes. I've taken three geology classes. I don't know what sodalite's used for, but it's just really pretty.
Okay.
I'm not sure what that is. I've never heard of that mineral before.
Okay.
Hematite, it's all same thing that's in here. Iron ore. We have some big old clams. Imagine having those for dinner.
Wow.
Yummy, yummy. Big old clams, but they're very old, and I don't think they taste very good. Calcite fizzes with acid.
Wow.
Fluorite makes these cool little hexagon shapes.
Wow.
What's here?
It's so cute.
Got some sedimentary rocks, it looks like. Got some basalt from the ocean floor.
Wow.
Made it under the sea.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like wet clay or something there.
Wow.
Got a big old agate here. That's been cut open. You just would think that looks like a rock, but then you cut it open and it looks like that on the inside. It's so cool.
Looks beautiful.
Big old piece of amethyst, oftentimes used in jewelry.
And it's sparkling.
Yeah, very sparkling. And that's a big old chunk of copper, 11 pounds.
Wow.
Very, very hefty.
Wow, you guys have a beautiful gallery here. It's beautiful. Thank you for the lecture. I've learned something.
Yay!
Your love for geology is infectious.
Can I show you the fish downstairs?
All right, let's go.
Let's go.
I've seen the fish before,
yeah,
but
I don't even know
anything about it. All right, guys. So we're going downstairs now to see the fish. And she's going to be telling me more about the fish. I actually didn't know there was goldfish in some other parts. I only usually see the fish just on the walkway there. But now she's going to show me details and explain. I hope you guys are learning a thing or two from this lecture, right? But I'm having fun. Thank you so much, Blue, for taking me on this tour. I'm so glad. Thank you so much.
This is our all salt water. We got a clownfish. Oh, look, he's posing for the camera. How rare.
Nemo.
Yeah, Nemo. We got Nemo and Dory. Yeah, we got yellow fin tang, sail fin tang. All these fish get quite big. My favorite fish in here is a red hawkfish, I think.
Where is it?
Let me see if I can find him. He's pretty elusive. He's not very photogenic.
Come on, say, here.
No, that's a clownfish.
No, there's
there he is. You found him. Good work. And there's a couple sea urchins in here. I think those are zoanthid coral, the green ones.
So my question is this.
Oh, filefish. Look at the filefish.
Looks, yeah, I can see this one that looks green, right?
Yeah, the filefish that is just biting on the rock. You see him spinning around the circle.
So are these things living things?
Yes, those are living things. That's what Petoskey stones are. Petoskey stones are fossilized versions of those.
Wow.
Look, like, now he's kind of out. You see him? He's looking at
me.
He's very cute. I love hawkfish. Mm.
I don't know their names.
Look at him!
Oh no, there he goes! I got you on camera.
Petoskey stones are just fossilized coral. And there's a couple sea urchins in here. There's one that's really prickly right here. It's kind of brown.
Sea urchins?
Yes, the spiky things.
Wow.
There's kind of one right here that's got really big spikes, and then over here there's one with little spikes, and you can even see its little tube feet sticking out. If we were to zoom in, you'd see its little feet moving. It tries to search for food. That's how they move along the bottom. If you look at the bottom, you can see them walking around, these little tube feet just going doop, 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 doop.
This is beautiful. So this is for what department? The biology department?
Yeah, these are saltwater fish. I've never kept saltwater fish before. I have this much experience with keeping saltwater fish.
So you were going to tell me about goldfish and why it's bad.
Goldfish are one of the most commonly kept species of pet fish. And I have no idea why. They make absolutely terrible pets to start off with. One adult goldfish needs a tank that is probably about the same size as this tank. One goldfish.
Why?
They get 12 inches long and make poop like no one would believe.
Bad
diarrhea, goldfish.
Oh my god.
They eat a lot, and goldfish are members of the carp family. They do not have stomachs. Food just passes right through their intestine because they're used to sitting on the bottom and sifting through the sediment to find little bits of food. So it does not make sense for them just to have a big stomach where all the food and sand goes, when they can just pass it right through and make the most out of what little nutrient they're getting. But most people feed them very rich foods like flakes and pellets, and that can cause a lot of issues. One of those issues being swim bladder problems and obesity in fish, and liver failure, all kinds of bad things that can happen if fish, especially goldfish, are not fed proper food. They get much bigger than most people think. 12 inches is big. And bigger than these guys.
These guys are little.
They're cute, even though some of these species get quite large. Look at the hawkfish! Look at him! He's just staring at the camera!
Oh, what's the name of this one?
Red hawkfish.
So beautiful. I love the white and black stuff.
Oh, that's a fox face.
Wow.
That yellow one is a fox face.
Looks like a horse.
Yes, of course.
Aww.
Yes.
So cute. Wow. Thank you so much, Blue. You've really made my day today, right?
Seriously, I wouldn't have been able to say anything about this stuff.
let's look at the goldfish. Let's see if the goldfish.
Is there a goldfish here?
Yeah. Goldfish are right
here. Wow.
I didn't know they had any place. I've never been to this side before.
The goldfish here are not kept very
well. Oh my god, I've never seen this place before.
Okay, come on. Let's see how many of them have swim bladder issues today.
So is this goldfish?
Yeah, these are all goldfish. They're not adult size, even though they're all adult age. They were all kept in less than ideal conditions. See how they're gulping at the surface?
Uh-huh.
They should not be doing that. If they engulf air, they will float to the top and they won't come back down.
Oh my god.
And there's a rusty, I think that's a rusty crayfish in there.
Wait, crab? Is that a crab?
Nope, crayfish. And he could easily grab that goldfish, and that goldfish goes bye-bye, he's dead.
Oh my god.
So I have no idea why they're keeping those two species together, but I guess if the goldfish gets sick, gotta clean up crew. But these guys are all really, really, really small. Goldfish get a lot bigger than this. These guys are not even close to a healthy adult size, even though I'm sure some of these individuals are probably over 5 years old, but they're not showing that for their size.
That's small.
Yeah. Wow. The thing that's kind of giving
they don't come to this side before. I just pass away.
The thing that's kind of giving it away for me that they're older than their size shows is if I look at their scales, there's some of them who have their normal scales, but these ones that are smaller, and they kind of have like a, their bodies look crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
Like this little orange one right here. His scales look crunchy. They look like they're made of like, I don't know. They just look crunchy. They just look off.
The silver one is
also goldfish. Do you see that one? How he keeps on floating to the top?
Mm-hmm.
That's a swim bladder issue.
Mm-hmm.
And he's also got fin rot on his tail.
Mm-hmm.
So, but they do better off in ponds and people who have much proper space. And this tank probably is about the same.
Yeah, see what they wrote. We are the goldfish. Sometimes we get roommates like crawfish and crabs. Other times we get visitors like Puff, who love to say hi and watch us.
Puff is the lizard in that cage over there. He's probably staring at us, actually. There he is. See if he's looking at us. Way over there.
I can't see it.
He's on the log. He's just sitting there.
Right inside there?
Yes, right inside there.
Oh.
He's kind of big, sitting on the log, kind of at the bottom.
I'm trying to see
his leg, tail.
Okay, I've seen it.
Yeah, you see
the same color with the log.
Yeah, same color as the log. Yep. Mm. But goldfish are also they need a pretty varied diet.
Are you kidding?
They need vegetable matter. They need.
So this is a biology laboratory, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Which. That's beautiful. Yeah. Yeah. Goldfish aren't the healthiest, but they're alive and they're not in a bowl. So I'm.
Can they be eaten?
Domestic? No. They probably have a lot of toxins in them, and they're probably really ill from being fed low quality food.
Yeah.
But yeah, and plus like the stuff you use to treat them, if someone, because like that one with fin rot right here, you're like, oh, I want to treat that and use some like Mellifix or something. You don't want to eat Mellifix.
Mm-hmm.
That's not something you want to eat. That's something you want to put in your body. Wow. But yeah, see, they keep on doing that as a service. Bad babies, you should not be doing that. You're gonna get-
Oh my God, I had a very beautiful time with Blue. And I don't know if you guys enjoyed this geology class. So please write down in the comment section, what did you learn? What did you enjoy about the geology class? And let me know if you would be coming over to pay your school fees. All right, guys. See you in my next video. God bless you all. Bye.